Hello, I'm Kevin Honeycutt, and I'm here to share a tutorial for people who are going to participate in the Bluemont Bell project. So first, the thing I want to do is screen share a little bit and give you a little background and just kind of tell you, if you haven't already gone to the Spark page to kind of look at the project, I want you to do that first, kind of give yourself some grounding in what this is all about. Okay, so if you look, you're going to see a video kind of giving you some background as to what we're doing here. And as Dean Mercer says, you can use any technique you wish, drawing, pencil, color, pencil, charcoal, pastels, I'd say, watercolor, collage, probably sculpture, and take a picture of a sculpture, whatever you want. But the size of your artwork, and let's talk about that just for a little bit. I'm going to stop sharing here for a minute and go over to a different camera here. Let's see the IP go here. Okay, so here's my paper here. So now this paper, if you get out a, this is just Xerox paper, right, that you would use in a regular printer, which is 11 by 8.5. And so for the purposes of this project, we need these things to be 10 by 8. Now, I like to go ahead and work on this size paper, then I can always trim it down the way I want to get it to 10 by 8 to hand it in, okay? But the most important thing is it's gotta be done by the deadline, which is Wednesday, September 30th, okay? So that Spark, that Adobe Spark page is gonna have some great information on it. Some of that is gonna be, you're gonna hit that Dropbox link, and please do what I did, go in there and read the book, the text of the book, because that really tells you a lot. And then there's a whole bunch of pictures. Let me just show you some of those pictures. There's a couple of things I keep on hand here. Now, one thing I'm going to do always is I print off some of my favorite pictures. And like, oh my gosh, this is a gorgeous one here with the sun in the background and the clouds and all of that. But here, this one gives me an idea of how that building is shaped. And so then I'm going to go in here, and this is my sketch based on that building. And I kind of included the placard a little bit. And what I'm really doing is sketching. This is not my final work, but I'm trying to put together some different images to sensitize myself so that I'm ready to start drawing. And I think if you're gonna write a story, you do research on the background, the characters and all of that, and then you start writing. You don't just take off. And as a visual artist or someone who's creating art, I think it's important to feed your brain first. So I'm looking at different pictures. Let's look at a couple of these here. Let's see here. We've got this one, which I found interesting. There were a couple that I looked at. I drew a couple of little quick sketches to get an idea, but honestly, it's a bell, you know, it's a bell. It's the history of the bell and the story behind the bell and the things that happened to the bell and all that it's been through, I think that make it particularly interesting, right? So I kind of like the contrast here. I like that picture there and what it could be. So that picture again is based on that picture, right? But there was foliage back here and trees. I decided not to do too many of the lights because I thought they would steal attention away from the bell. That was just my particular take on it, right? So let's play around with some ideas here. If we were gonna surround ourselves, and here's what I do. I'm gonna show you kind of what I do here. Let's go here and go to here. Now, in my studio here, I've got right over there where you can't see just below the camera, I've got an easel there. Where I can take things like this. So I just want to keep the images of the bell, where it was from and all that stuff. So foremost in my mind as I start to draw, right? And I know that I'm drawing horizontally on this Xerox paper, but let me put this just, I'm sticking this right here on my little easel so I can see. Okay, piece of tape here so it doesn't fall off. And then that will be right in front of me. And again, I'm keeping the story in mind, some of the things the bell has done, and really the overall philosophy that the bell is calling, you know, it's calling you to be a teacher. I don't want to forget that. I don't want to forget that that's what's going on in the picture here. So I'm going to just do some doodling here with a couple of different mediums to kind of get you. But here's the complexity of what I'm trying to do here. I don't want you to draw like me. I don't want you to draw what I draw exactly. What I want you to do is look for images that you like and give yourself permission to draw. Now, if they end up looking childlike, good. Education is about teaching children in many cases, so that's okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. In this situation, I believe perfect is the enemy of done, right? So what I want to do is get I'm gonna get my paper ready here, and I'll show you a couple of different ways that I can draw. This could be crayons again. This could be markers. Let me go to my my dot cam here and get that one up on the screen here. So now a couple things. I've got these Conte crayons, which are awesome because they come in this beautiful case here. And what it really is just every beautiful kind of color pencil here that I could draw with. So that's color pencil. If you want to draw fast with lots of expression, I recommend pastels. They're messy, so they smear a little bit, but man, I love drawing with them for quick and vibrant color. These are just Sharpies that I could use these to draw with too. Typically when I use Sharpies, I'll draw first with a mechanical pencil or something that I can erase after I've done my marker work. So what I want to do is just a really quick sketch with and using some Sharpies here. So I'm going to divide my paper up into four quadrants just to give you ideas. And I might start with a sketch. Let's say you start with a sketch and you think, dang, that sketch is so good. I want that to be my final drawing. Then I would send you over to the window, light table, right, or window, so that you can trace that onto another piece of paper that's clean and just really work on making that what you want it to be. Okay, so let's just do something simple here. I'm going to draw the bell right over here, and I'm going to draw it in mechanical pencil and just start with something simple here. So I'm just going to kind of go across the top, kind of come down and see right real quickly the bell goes from being kind of a cylinder to kind of, and by the way, you have to get both sides to sort of match here. So I'm going to come down here and remember, this is all erasable. I always make my first lines very light or at least light enough that I know I can completely erase them for the final drawing. And so again, they're sort of speculative there at the beginning. This is going to go like this and a little bit like this. And then you're going to have that curve, right? It comes this way. And this is really an ellipse. So really this is going to come this way. So it's an oval or an ellipse, kind of a closed ellipse in this particular view that I'm looking at. And it's got the apparatus over at the top. Now I'm not going to draw too much with pencil because I intend to make this my marker drawing. Okay. So I'm going to make some structures here. And remember, this doesn't have to be photorealistic. If we wanted photorealistic, we'd just take the pictures that already exist and put those in the book. What we want is what you create. Your translation of that image is through the pencil, the marker, the crayon. Really, that's the work of education and teaching kids to have the confidence to draw, you know, and create without feeling like it has to be perfect. So again, I just want you to kind of unleash yourself and say, you know what, close enough. It's close enough. What's most important is it looks like a bell and that it enhances my experience and the people's experience of this book that's going to be created, which is going to be so much fun to be a part of. Cindy's classes, it's just really cool. And if anyone gets really stuck there and they need to contact me and they just want to do a Zoom call and show me their work so far and let me kind of give them some ideas, I would love to do that. Now, this is enough. This is a quick sketch. I know I'm going to use markers, so I'm going to go and look for, in the picture that I'm using, there's a lot of gold, there's some green, there's some brown, honestly. So I'm going to grab some different colors here, from yellow to green, to darker green here, a couple of these. And remember, I'm trying to make this sort of fast, loose, fun, expressive, okay, more so than making it look like a photograph, okay. So I'm just going to look for places to drop in some color here, and let's say I drop in a little bit over here on the edge, and a little bit over here of this color, and I can drop in some color here, and then over top of it, I'm going to make it darker, because that's the inside of the bell, and less light gets into that area. Just here and there, I'm going to drop in just a little bit of color, and I'm going to go in here. This thing is goldish to copperish in that ballpark, so I hit go yellow, and then go on top of the yellow with other colors to kind of knock it down so it's not quite so bright. Let's put some, let's go here and look for some highlights on the bell itself. And there's some other things happening in here. Again, highlights here and there. Now I'm gonna jump over here and grab another color or two. Let's go with a brown. That brown is a little too dark. Let's go with a peach color here, perhaps, yeah. Peach color, pull it together. There's just not much there. A little bit. I'm going to darken under here. So I'm going to use one of my pencils together with my marker. I'm going to go up here and use the side of my pencil to get a wider line up in here and create contrast with that apparatus that holds the bell right there. So that pops a little bit. There's a lot of green in the background. I'm going to start with light, and I'm going to just go right up against the edge of the bell to create contrast or pop. Then I'm going to go into that sort of scribble thing because these are all leaves on a tree in the background. So I'm just going to, again, strip that line carefully and kind of walk that out a little ways. Remember, this is my sketch, my ideation thing. It could become my drawing, but right now this is a smaller sketch with my sort of scribblism going on there a little bit. If I go in here and hit that, I'm going to get some contrast there if I want that. And again, keeping it loose so that it looks like a human drew it. I think that's good. I think, you know, it's okay if it's a little bit general. It's a sketch. It's a quick suggestion. Hey, here's what I'm drawing to go with the book, okay? So all of those lines and the way you choose to do them and your personality coming through in the way you draw it is what we're looking for here, is that translation through the lens of a human who's looked at this bell, read the story, and been inspired, okay? So that might be the beginning of a marker approach here. I'm going to get rid of these markers here, and I'm going to go to a pencil, more of a pencil approach here, and I'm using these, again, these design ebonies. They make dark lines. They do smear. I'm left-handed, so if you're drawing this direction, you can smear your hand right through your shading, and sometimes that will be, you know, that might be something that that you're working against, and you're trying to erase all that stuff after the fact. So I'm gonna go up here, and this one I'm gonna do a combination of images. So I'm gonna do some quick sketching. Again, I'm not gonna let this turn into an architectural drawing. I wanna do some quick sketching here. So I'm gonna go back to one of the structures that's part of the story, and you will see this in the images, and you will read this in the story. But this particular building here, which is this such an interesting Gothic building, and it's, to me, it's like drawing a rocket in a way. When you look at the way this thing looks as it comes, and as it comes down the roof here, and this thing comes down in front of the building, and you can go across here. To me, it's a very sort of Gothic Revival building. You go like this, and over here. And again, I'm not trying to make this perfect. Let's look how sort of sketchy it is here. But I want to try to represent the images that I see in the picture here, okay? So I'm gonna go over here and get the other gable. I'm gonna come down. Now, I'm not investing too much because this is not the only part of the picture that matters to me in this imagery here, okay? So some important things like the front entryway, establishing that these things come up, these elements come up to a Gothic at the point at the top here, and a couple of windows here. Right, and this is good like this, and just leave it sort of imbued with this sort of approximate, sort of very human, almost like I'm sketching it from memory, right? Let's go over here, and over here, and over here, and over here. And this building goes on. I mean, it's connected to other things, but that's not what I want to happen here. I want that much of that building over there. And again, this is almost like an underpainting from a sketching point of view. But now I'm going to look at one of the other images, and it's going to be clear that because of the proportions, these two images are separate but part of the same picture. Okay, so now I'm just going to kind of have fun with a picture of the bell, a bigger picture of the bell, and let that sort of become what I'm drawing now. And I don't think of that as much. If I happen to overlap it, I overlap it. But what's most important is that I focus on these different elements here that make this thing look like it looks. So in the bottom, there's this sort of line there, and there's some lines here at the top, right? And then the part that holds the bell on comes across, and then there's this whole part that sort of lets you ring the bell, this part that's sort of circular that's connected to the apparatus that's holding the bell up or together. Let's go like this here. Okay, for that part there, then this is going to come over and go like that, and just let it go right off the frame. Right, let's look there again, some of that apparatus. It goes up this way, and it's going to go back this way, like spokes almost, right? And then you might go back and say, okay, are there some things we want to know? Well, yeah, this was dedicated to Richard House, Dr. Richard House, and he's this amazing education professor who had classes like making education creative or creativity in the classroom. Interesting, you know, and that would be just the kind of guy that would be part of this sketch here, because we're drawing, and drawing entails creativity. So I know it was 1996 when it was rededicated, so I could include 19, right? Let's see, 1996 in here without even explaining, because the person's reading the book, they're going to get that, oh, that must be, you know, a salute to Dr. House and his wife, who took the time to figure out how to dedicate, you know, this bell, rededicate it to this gentleman who spent so much of his life creating more teachers. So that 1996 is part of that there, right? And it's the Bluemont Bell. So that Bluemont could be back here in the background, and you could begin spelling, right? So I think where the U would be, and then the E would be, and then the M would be, right? And this is just kind of fun. What I want you to do is just think about how can I have fun with this? Don't let yourself get caught up in trying to make some perfect thing. Again, there's going to be kids who contribute to this book, elementary kids. And just like us to have fun with some of the things about this thing here. Now, I can go in here and add some shading. Yeah, you have to use the side of the pencil to create contrast. And again, the way you work that pencil in different ways to create these sort of faceted elements inside the picture. Right, that's the front here to pop that thing up. And maybe this is lighter back here, but still contrasts some of the things. You can go darker on the words if you want to, right? But now you've got this sort of beginnings of what I would call sort of an abstract or expressionistic take on the bell. So this is a little more like the bell might actually look. And over here, you've got something that's a little more montage or collage. Again, now, how would you do this? Well, if you drew this and you thought it's pretty good, you know, and I want to put the bell beside it. I already drew the bell. So if I just take that bell and put it underneath my picture, put it on the window and trace the bell through, now I've got that element. Let's say I don't do lettering very well over here or numbers very well. Print that off on your computer, put that underneath your artwork and trace that through. Little by little, you're going to build up this sort of look that this thing has. And I think, you know, in the end, it's going to be fun. I think it's going to be fun. So think about the bell, what the bell says. And again, you can do so much. Let me give you one more crazy idea here. Let me just get this off of here and grab another one. Let's go a little more freeform abstract, okay? So let's, we know it's going to be a bell. We know it's kind of going to come down, and it's going to have the same kind of shape it had there in the other drawings. I'm going to make it more about the bell this time. And I'm going to think about, you know, listen and you can hear the call, right? So what's happening with the bell? Well, you know, every bell has this part of the bell that, you know, hits against the side and creates this image. And if you read the story, you'll see, you could hear it, I think something like 5 miles, and people describe the clear tone of the bell calling kids to class in its original form, you know, and how, what kids did to try to silence the bell so they didn't have to go to class. There's so much good story there. But like, what's coming out of the bell, right? If you think about, you know, what the bell is saying, or what comes from the bell, or, you know, maybe this is, there's emanations of sound that have come out of the bell, and how many teachers were created or brought into being because of the bell. And yes, people who've been educated, maybe because they went to class because of the bell. And, you know, if you read the story, some of the kids who sabotaged the bell later on become educational leaders at the same institution. So it's interesting stuff. Anyway, so the vibrations coming from the bell, you know, that could be something that you focus on. As the bell is moving, what those motion marks look like, what happens in the background, you know. Maybe there's a textbook over here. Let's just do that real quick and kind of show what that might look like. They write an open book, which is kind of a symbol of learning. And there's the cover here, and maybe there's some sort of approximation of illustrations and text here. Maybe there is a bookmark here. And you just sort of have fun with that. And look how I'm just not letting myself get crazy here, kind of having fun with that. And as I'm drawing and bringing in different elements, let's say I want to bring in just the top of this building, right? Just the very top with that roof. Let's go do that for a minute, right? And it has these interesting sort of Gothic small windows here, which are just fun to draw. And then I'm gonna go here, and it has this other little row of little windows, and then it comes up to that very sharp peak, right? It's gonna have this here, there, and then maybe a couple of those things there. And I'm gonna let that. These are, let's get some of these over here. Let's let this sort of run into the bell itself, the roof run into this, and this whole thing dissolve into the other image. Right, so you've got elements. It's almost like you took a book and you took different pages and you put them all into one image to leave people with a feeling about something. Let's go up here and look at the surround here, the thing that holds the ball in place. Let's say we get that up here at the top. You know, how's it held on there exactly? This goes over behind this, you know, and you can go in here and start creating contrast between things. And again, I just like to leave it like a sketch, leave it like a memory, leave it like the alumni are trying to remember the bell and somehow draw the sound of the bell. I know that sounds crazy. So at the end of the day, right? And I show you, there's that little crazy image, and we had the one with markers, and we had the one with pencil, and again, this could be watercolor. A couple of things I want you to think about is keep this simple, make it fun, come up with what you come up with, and allow yourself to be who you are when you're trying to express the bell. Do sensitize yourself with some of the history, look at the images, and just sort of be honest. This is not about collecting a bunch of artists or art majors to do this. We could have done that. What we're trying to do is take education majors who will probably be drawing on chalkboards or dry erase boards or smart boards with your kids at some point anyway. So just be the teacher you are. Have fun with this. I can't wait to see how the book comes out. If you need any help, give me a yell. Cindy knows how to reach me too. Go get them. Good luck. Have fun.